Okay, hello everybody, IDWLED here. Welcome to my Let's Play slash walkthrough of Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. As you may have noticed on my channel, I'm not really used to doing all the commentary stuff, but I'd like to change that, so this is actually my first walkthrough or Let's Play that I'm going to do with commentary. So, I hope you'll enjoy it. I had this game in my Steam library for quite some time already, but I've been setting up a bit for all this commentary business. I've been getting a new microphone, trying to get used to all the tweaks that I have to do to get a nice mic quality out and set up all the audio issues and whatnot. So I hope everything will turn out okay, and most of all, I hope you all will enjoy it. So let's get started. I've played it a bit before, just to test the audio indeed, if the levels are all okay, so I do have a save slot already. But we're just gonna start a new game. Let's see, story. New game. Reset progress, yes. Okay, and hard, because pretty much all games lately on hard are just easy.
So far in just 3 short years.
The sign of a strong leader, sir.
No. The will of a strong people. And one very able advisor.
Thank you, sir.
Your team deserves credit as well. Mr. Lightning Bolt.
Just doing our job, Mr. Prime Minister.
I must admit, I once thought of groups like yours as opportunists, enablers of war. But you've trained our new army well. Order has returned sooner than expected. Perhaps I was wrong about these private military companies.
We prefer private security providers, sir. Most of Maverick's contracts do focus on security.
Yes, well, the security can mean many things.
There's a saying I like. One sword keeps another in the sheath. Sometimes the threat of violence alone is a deterrent. Sometimes by taking a life, others can be preserved. It's the code the samurai lived by.
A soldier and a philosopher. You are full of surprises, Mr. Lightning Bolt.
I could say the same about you, Mr. Prime Minister.
What is happening?
Someone's blocking a lead vehicle. Hold on.
Clear the road! This is official state business!
Out of there.
Yes, sir.
Stay calm.
He's got friends on our 12.
Raiden!
I'm on it. Guard the Prime Minister.
Okay, now as you probably noticed, I've been a bit quiet during the cutscene, because, well, I kind of like to get involved in the story as well, so I want to listen to the story, check out all the animations and all the effort the developers put into it. So yeah, I'll do my best to stay quiet during the cutscenes, because personally when I watch Let's Plays, I just can't stand it how people just constantly keep talking and talking through all the cutscenes. It really distracts me from the story and trying to enjoy the game for what it is. So yeah, you won't hear me talking that much, or at least I'll really try to keep quiet during all the cutscenes. But during gameplay, it's all fair game. So let's slice up some fools.
The limo is in trouble. Get back there, ASAP. I'll add the limo to your solid down radar.
I've done this part already, so we'll just kill these three guys real quick. And then we'll continue on to the next area. Also gives me a chance to refamiliarize myself with the controls a bit, because I am pretty new to this game. One more. Okay, let's get out of here. Before I'm out of health.
So you're Jack.
What do you want with the Prime Minister?
I want him dead. Nothing personal, of course. Africa's just getting a bit too peaceful.
What?
Business ain't been the same since they shut down SOP. A clean break from the war economy. Huh. Well, some of us like that economy. How's an honest warmonger supposed to make a living?
This is your answer? Don't do it!
Don't worry now. I won't. Not while he's still useful. So long.
What? They have a metal gear? Gear?
Okay, let's get some help. Oh, ass! Oh no 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 no! Hell no! Not now! Not when I'm just starting. Come on. Where's that health? Thank you. Yeah, I've watched some Let's Plays of this game already for the Xbox 360, I believe, especially from Milby from the Mindcrackers, and well. I'm always pretty jelly about high-quality titles like this that are only exclusive for the PlayStation and for the Xbox 360 and whatnot. Just like Beyond Two Souls and The Last of Us. I really want to play those games, but I don't think it's worth it to just buy a console for that, for just for those exclusive games. So, yeah, I always just dearly hope they eventually bring that to the PC, just like this game, because then I'll definitely buy it. Come on, stop jumping. No, no.
They swapped out the hydraulic cutter for a plasma cannon. Use blade mode to damage its armor.
Oh! Okay, I didn't see that one before. I do know that. Piss off.
Use the ninja man to dodge that plasma.
Close. actually pick the lift. Come on, stop jumping. Stop it! Ooh. Working on it. My god. You know, ever since I started experimenting with this, I just found it incredibly impressive about all those other Let's Players and people that do commentary. How the hell do you keep your focus during all that combat and all that action? Like, how do you keep track of what you do, what you have to do, and still keep all the commentary going? I just find that so impressive. It's absolutely insane how they do that. But probably just practice makes perfect, but still. It will take quite some getting used to for me.
There, get him.
Oh, how cute. He's been waiting for me.
Use your ninja van to move over obstacles automatically. Do not let him out of your sight. You must catch him.
Uh-oh. Oh, okay. Last time I did this, I was taking the stairs, and I was like, ah, that's not too smart. Where are you gonna put that laser? Oh! That's probably the hardest one to dodge. As long as you jump early, you should be fine. Come on. Oh no! Ah! And that
one. Use blade mode to take down those heavy missiles.
Oh. Whoa. I hate those close calls. It really makes my toes curl up. Ow. That's fine, give me more health. Dodge that! I should have been able to dodge that. Again! I haven't been able to dodge that one yet, damn it. Finally! What are you gonna do? Oh, okay. Oh, really? Oh yeah, missiles. I'm holding it! What are you talking about? Well, that was the right bumper, not the right trigger. Oh well. Where's the damn Paco? I know there's Paco here somewhere. Oh, nice. One Metal Gear down. I love that. It's just so badass. It's just all so over the top. The music is really nice as well. Just the acting is a bit cheesy.
Stop! about all the good things war has done for us?
Why don't we ever hear speeches about that? Jobs, technology, a common purpose?
Raiden, forget me. Stop him.
You ain't listening. Mind if I got in? All we're saying, give war a chance!
No!
This guy's gonna kick my ass so hard. First time I did this, he just like one combo and half my health was gone. Something like that.
Self-taught. And not half bad. Still. Your technique lacks something.
Okay, well, at least I managed to do one block against him.
Now I see. You deny your weapon its purpose. Blood of your enemies, but you hold it back. No. My sword is a tool of justice.
First, I wasn't sure why he actually said that, but then some of the other Let's Players said something like in the previous Metal Gears, in the previous Metal Gear games or something, they also lost his legs. So this was probably was after that.
This is what happens when you bring a tool to a sword fight. It's over. Lucky devil.
Get you waiting, huh?
That was quite a first chapter. It's a really nice, strong beginning. I always like that.
Safely, Tovaric. Just relax and enjoy the ride.
Right.
Can you hear me, Raikou?
Doctor.
Remember the two procedures to maintain your new body. One, seizing nano repair units
from your foes. And two,
absorbing their electrolytes. I got it.
Yes, enemy cyborgs should provide plenty of MCFC electrolytes once you slice them open and extract their fluids.
They're terrorists. I was planning on that anyway.
Oh, and their left hands, if you please.
Excuse me?
Is that combat data stored on holographic memory, typically located in the left hand? That data is very valuable. I am authorized to offer you upgrades and services in exchange for it.
How generous.
Ich liebe Kapitalismus. Had the world come down a few years earlier, I would have a Nobel Prize on my shelf.
There, I see land.
3 miles out, closing.
No activity at the airbase. Looks like we don't need to worry about interceptors.
Great. Then we have time for a quick briefing.
I know you miss me, Kev, but I've been all over the materials.
That's what you said before Montenegro. Look, just humor me, buddy. Objectives, of course, are enter Abkhazia, neutralize the terrorists, and restore the rightful government, or what's left of it anyway. The president and most of the cabinet have been killed, and a military junta's been established.
The terrorists brainjacked all the high-ranking officers, and their cyborgs scattered the rank and file. The few leaders who have survived have no way of openly opposing the new regime. That's why they called us.
Andrei Dolzaev, leader of the occupation forces, an extremist linked to both the St. Petersburg massacre of 2015 and last year's terror spree in Georgia. And his arms supplier? None other than Desperado Enforcement, LLC.
Imani's killers.
If we don't stop them here, they could destabilize the entire region. But our more immediate problem is Jetstream Sam.
I believe you've met.
The only problem I see is that nickname. I've got my enhancements this time. He won't be an issue.
He may not even be in country. But keep an eye out, Justin.
Oh. Sorry. Ready for insertion.
Raiden, you landed safely, huh? First, head inland. The waypoint is marked on your Solidan radar. Contact us on Codec if you have questions.
Okay, guys. I would like to call the first episode here. So I'm gonna cut off here, make some tweaks, see if I can get some nice video quality again and audio quality. I hope you all enjoyed it, and I hope to see you all back for the second episode and the rest of the walkthrough. So, see y'all laters!